stands probably the best pillar in all of the stars. This system offers a pretty good moveset to match with the title of a living room.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the 7th episode of Games in Motion. As you can see, that was our new intro, and our theme music, originally composed by a person known as Money Menace. Well, in this episode, we will be reviewing several new games, and next week will probably be a flashback. So look forward to that. Fortunately, we will have no Games Right Now segment in this episode, due to a lack of time. Our first game today is Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, coming out on the Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and PC systems. This game is the latest installment of the Assassin's Creed series and adds a lot more into the game. The graphics on this game are better than Assassin's Creed 2's, but just by a little bit. Otherwise, the game itself is pretty much the same thing. Although we do get a new single-player campaign, where our hero, Eos, has to take on the next ruler of the kingdom. This time it's a girl, and she plans for an evil monarch. This game takes place during the Industrial Age, and this adds a lot into the story, seeing as we are now using cannibals, and we see warships now, which we have to take down. One of the biggest things they added into this new game is the new multiplayer modes. This is probably what will make the game most unique, since they have added new online modes where you can take on other assassins worldwide. This adds a lot into the old Assassin's Creed gameplay, since they never really had much of a multiplayer system before. Also, there are several battlegrounds for you to compete in now. This game is really enhanced on the whole Brotherhood part. Next, we go to Activision's Call of Duty Black Ops, which comes out on the Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and PC systems. This game, which I mentioned in last week's Games Right Now, is a very big hit for all systems. It has grossed a lot of money and is viewed as one of the best Call of Duty games ever. This game's graphics are a little better than Modern Warfare's because of all the new little details they have added, which make the game look more real, such as hand details, gun details, and stuff like that. This game takes place during the Cold War and has gotten a lot of flack because of this. Most don't like how you have to destroy Fidel Castro in the main storyline. Also, you have to destroy many other Cold War enemies. This game's multiplayer has also improved a lot, which is hard to believe since the other versions were already great. We see new multiplayer modes such as Gamble, which is where you can risk all your money in a match, and if you win, you keep the jackpot. If you lose, well, this game looks very promising for the Call of Duty series. Our last game is Sega's Sonic Colors, which comes out for the Wii platform. This game has been a Wii exclusive release and looks very promising for the Wii system. With the recent release of Sonic Riders Zero Gravity for the Kinect, Sega has truly outdone itself with Sonic games. This game's title may sound a bit stupid, but the game itself is very fun. It takes place as the usual Sonic games do, in a battle against the evil Dr. Eggman. This time you have to collect these bracelets with the colors in them in order to destroy Eggman and save the world. This game also takes Sonic back to its roots, with a mostly side-scrolling 3D game format. You also see many exotic Sonic zones, just like in the old games. We see zones in Space Zone, we see zones made out of candy, and loads more, which adds to this game's colorful atmosphere. This game is great for families, and also a great game for Sonic fanboys. Now we will head to the reviews. First, Assassin's Creed Brotherhood gets 7.5 stars. This game is a great addition in the Assassin's Creed saga and adds much more for players to do, such as the new multiplayer capabilities and a brand new storyline. We see this game as an epic sequel to the already great Assassin's Creed series because of all the stuff it includes, but it also does have some downsides. This game's story is a little different from the other games since it is in the Industrial Age, and we see less and less of the fun killing someone from behind and assassin techniques. Also, we expected a greater graphics difference from Assassin's Creed 2, but no such thing comes. All in all, though, this is a great sequel and will offer Assassin's Creed players a lot more to do. Next, Activision's Call of Duty Black Ops gets 8 stars. This game is a lot of fun and adds so much more to do in the Call of Duty series. We have so many new multiplayer modes, and the campaign is very interesting. Another thing we greatly enjoyed was the re-addition of zombies into this game. This is a lot of fun and adds an extra feature for players to do. Downsides to this game, though, is the general weapon arsenal. It is a little sad compared to Modern Warfare 2. In Modern Warfare 2, we had a lot of great weapons to choose from, which really made the game feel customizable. We also would have liked to see a greater reintroduction of vehicles, besides a little derby car. But I guess that's all we'll have for now. Last, we have Sega's Sonic Colors, which gets 7 stars. This game is a lot of fun and it brings Sonic back to its roots. With the new addition of the 3D side-scrolling, it makes this game feel old but new again. It also makes the zone choice feel very unique from any other Sonic game. Some downsides we saw, though, was that this game is a Wii-only release. This really bums us, since most of the Sonic games have been experienced on all platforms, especially the 3D ones, and we think this game would be great for more than just Wii. Although the recent release of Sonic 4 for all systems has come out, it's just not the same as having a great 3D game coming out. Also, we think that this game could have done a little better story, since the old thing again, fighting Dr. Eggman. And we would like to see a new villain personally, because Dr. Eggman, well, we think he should just stay dead once in a while. For Sonic fanboys, this is a great game, and I think most Wii players will enjoy it as well. Well, that's it for Games in Motion Episode 7. We hope you enjoy the new music and logo. Remember, next week will probably be our flashback episode. This is Reporter Zach, signing off.